Hi there, beautiful. I'm here to show you how to cut yourself out from your background in any photo, and it's going to be quick and easy with a free mobile app that works both on iOS and Android. So let's get into it. So the app that you want to download, if you're using iOS, it's called Background Eraser. It has a little squiggle on it and it's written stickers. I'll show you what the icon looks like. And if you're on Android, it's also called Background Eraser. And what you also need to check out, because I know there's a lot of them that's going to pop up, is the one that has kind of like the boxes and squares, just like what I'm going to show you. And that's how it looks both on Android and on iOS. So what you want to do is open your app. And then this is what you're going to see, where it's written Background Eraser, load photo, copy image, resume, and all these other things. And just know that because this is a free app, you are going to you're going to see ads, and they're going to be in your photo, but it's just going to be for like 5 minutes and then you are done. You're going to go where it says load a photo, and then once we're there, I'm going to go to my favorites because I have photos that are already loaded. So I'm going to show you with three different examples that are real quick, and then I'm going to show you how you can apply it, whether you want to make like a thumbnail, whether you want to put it on your background art, whatever that you want to do it. It actually works. So the first picture that I'm going to use is this one over here. It is a very vivid background. It's like I want to cut myself out of that background and put myself anywhere. So you can choose the dimensions that you want: 1x1, 3x2, 3x4, 9x16, however you want. So for me, I'm just going to do it as a free baller. So once you do that, you say done, and it automatically removes your background by itself. So what you want to do is, sometimes it might take out parts that you don't want to take out. You want to go where it says repair. So repair is where you go on the parts where you want to bring back things that were taken out, and manual is when you want to cut out some stuff that you want in your photo that were taken out. So we're going to go where it says repair. So you see this little blue icon that's here. You can actually extend it if you want your eraser or the icon that's going to rub or put back your things. If you want it to be big, it makes it easier. But if you're working on a small area, you want to make it small. But I want it big because I want to repair this area right here. By my pants area, it kind of took out stuff I didn't want to be taken out. And you can even zoom in. You can zoom in with your fingers just to check if everything is fine, if there's no parts of you that were taken out or not. So then I'm gonna zoom back out. You can just pinch the picture and then it will zoom back out. This one was the easiest of all. I repaired, it didn't erase anything that I didn't want to erase, and I think I'm good to go. After you're done, you just press done. And if you want to further, you know, kind of have it that feathery magical look, you can do that. For me, I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to leave it as is. You can choose to have a white background or a transparent one. I want a transparent one so that I can move it wherever that I want. So then I go ahead and I press save, and it succeeded to save. Then you say done. Check that one out. The background is totally gone. And when you place it in something else, you're going to see how transparent it's going to get. But we're going to go back to the app, and I'm going to do a second picture. So I'm going to go to my favorites and choose this picture right here where I'm holding cameras. I'm okay with how it's looking. You can crop it if you want, but I'm just going to leave it the way it is. Then I'm going to say done, and it automatically erases. But you see, when I zoom in right over here, there's parts of the background that are still there that I want to be gone. This is where we go to the manual button. Press manual, then press these keys right on the side. I want my pencil or the eraser to be really tiny so that it doesn't interfere with anything else I'm trying to erase. If you make a mistake, just go where there's the little arrows, the blue ones, to reverse something that you made. So you just click on the parts. If you want to erase, go to the parts with the little boxes. And if you want to repair, click on your actual picture so that you don't go and repair something that you don't want to repair. Anyways, we're going to be try and be nice and smooth. I'm going to make it much bigger. So you're just kind of rubbing out so that your background can be much cleaner. I'm trying to have a very smooth hand whilst I'm doing this. Otherwise, it's going to be a lot of work for me. All right. I think I'm okay with that. Then I'm gonna put my cursor away and put it on repair so that it doesn't mess up anything else I didn't want to be messed up. I think I'm okay with everything. When you say done is when you actually see if the job was well done or not. Look at that cutout. It's so perfect. So I'm happy with that. I still want a transparent background and we are good to go. We go ahead and we save and we say done. Okay. So now where we show how fun it was to do this, I'm going to go ahead and use Canva. So on top there, I'm just going to say YouTube channel art. Or sorry, it's already here. So you're just going to pick a blank canvas, or you can pick any of the colorful ones if you just want to see how your picture is going to look. I'm going to do two examples. So for the first one where it says like Happy Mother's Day, we can just slightly move it maybe to this corner, maybe take out one of these flowers, just delete. I'm trying to make space so that we can put that picture that we cut out, and then we can even change what's there. So for argument's sake, we're gonna go away the plus button that's in the corner, the purple one, and we are going to look, going to camera roll, going to that photo that I cut out, and shebang, there is no background. Are we seeing this? Like, are we seeing this together? There is no background. Like, girl, this is it. And then I'm gonna go ahead and save this. This is just to demonstrate that this is how it will look when you have like a transparent background. But anyways, just to show you just another quick example, you can choose a black canvas, something just plain and simple. You can choose a blank canvas and then just add your photo. And then I'm gonna go ahead to camera roll and add my photo. As you can see, it comes up and pops up right there. And it's transparent, it's good. I can write, I can add text, whatever that I wanna do, and I'll be good to go. Then I can just go ahead and add text real quick. Just gonna put my name. Tatenda Henani. And then I'm just gonna move it. Put it right here and then just stretch it out a bit. And then we're good to go. I'm gonna go ahead and save the image. Save. It's preparing the design. I just wanna show you how transparent it is when it's like done. And there we go. You've separated your background from your photos and you are good to go. So it's that easy. It just automatically cuts it out for you. And you can then go ahead. If it's not perfect, you go to manual and erase more background. If there was some of the seeping in of the erasement of the background, you go ahead and go to repair and then you repair your photo. That's what easy peasy. You can now make your thumbnails, your cover art, or anything that you want to do. You can cut yourself out of your background and you're good to go. Thank you so much for watching this video. Much love and light. Please like, subscribe for more videos like this. Check out my Tech Talk with Tate playlist for more helpful tips like this. Otherwise, I'll see you in my next one. Bye for now.